Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, friends. Welcome back to my channel. This Delta Electronics power supply is not turning on. Let's see what's wrong here. If you don't have good experience in electronics, never try to repair, because here are live voltage. In this power supply, fuse was damaged. MOSFET in PFC section, it was damaged. In my last video, I told IGBT. It is not IGBT. It is MOSFET. Its part number is 20N60C3, and we found one diode damage, fuse and other things. In this power supply we found fuse, these two diodes, these were damaged, and today we will see this one. I will apply power using series lamp and we will monitor the lamp condition in power on time and in repair process. Let's start. No indication on the lamp. AC voltage 234.5 to 235 volt, and if we check DC voltage, no output. AC input present, no output. Let's open it. Before touching to the circuit, always verify voltage on this capacitor. No voltage here. This is fuse and line area. Here is bridge rectifier at this point, and PFC section, MOSFET and rectifier, and here is something wrong. So let's check it. First we will verify the fuse. Fuse open circuit. I will connect 1 ampere bus fuse wire just for test purpose. Yes, there is short circuit on DC rail. Bridge rectifier positive terminal and negative terminal, short circuit continuity. So we have short circuit on DC rail. Set multimeter to diode. Red lead at bridge rectifier positive terminal, diode. It is wrong reading. When we connect positive lead at positive terminal, red lead at positive terminal, it must give open circuit. So it is wrong reading. Negative terminal, red lead, one diode. Negative lead at negative terminal, this is wrong reading. It must be open circuit. Here it's giving reading, that means we have short circuit on DC rail, that is this short circuit. Check at MOSFET, this MOSFET is short circuit. We apply line voltage, neutral. After protections, AC terminal, AC terminal. Then from positive terminal, this is negative terminal. Here is inductor. And here is diode. Between this, here is switching device, MOSFET, IGBT, transistor, whatsoever. Here is PFC controller. Voltage present here will be measured by controller, and it will switch this MOSFET, this IGBT, this transistor, and it will create magnetic field in this coil. That magnetic field will be stored in the core when this PFC controller will turn off this MOSFET. At that time, this voltage will add in the bridge rectifier output, and we will receive voltage here at this capacitor. So it will maintain this voltage around 390-400 volt DC. Here 310 volt. When this transistor is short circuit, it will create directly short link between positive to negative. To control the switching, to maintain the voltage, here is PFC controller. This PFC controller will measure voltage here, will measure voltage here, and then it will switch this device. It will create magnetic field in this PFC choke, and it will add the voltage in bridge rectifier's voltage. To power up this PFC controller, here is power supply. This power supply will provide biasing voltage, VCC voltage, for this chip, PFC controller, PWM controller, 3845 or 2845, and this operational amplifier, comparator, operational amplifier. So this is standby section. It provides power to all the ICs within this circuit. This MOSFET is short circuit. 20N60C3 Infineon. And I am thankful for my viewer who indicated in my last video that it is not IGBT. I told in my video that it is IGBT, but it is not IGBT, it is MOSFET. Gate to source, gate to drain, full channel and gate damaged. When it is damaged in this way, most of the time these components are damaged, and it will damage this chip. Check continuity from positive to negative terminal. Now there is no continuity, there is no short circuit. Now there is no short circuit on positive to negative terminal because we removed this faulty component. When all these three pins are damaged, it will damage this IC. That is pin number 8 of this PFC controller. So most of the time this PFC controller is also damaged. From positive terminal to capacitor positive terminal, one side open diode, second side one diode. So it is good indication. That means if we apply voltage here, that voltage will reach at this capacitor. First we will verify this power supply section and we will measure the voltage. Now, yes, that's nice. Power supply is turned on. Check voltage at output. Yes, we have output. Check voltage on this VCC capacitor. 8.6 volt. still these voltage are loaded. Verify voltage on this capacitor before touching to the board. Now it is safe to touch. I will remove this IC. It is 54 B65. Now let's verify voltage again. Yes, now it's good. That means this chip is also damaged. When this damaged chip was here was around 8 volt, but now 11.4. That is good reading. Check voltage on this capacitor. 14.5, that's nice. When the voltage was loaded due to this damaged chip, here were just only 11 volt, I think. 12.6 volt, good. 11.9, that's good. Now I need to install MOSFET, PFC chip, gate drive components, and this circuit will restore to fully functional condition. If you enjoyed this video, give a thumb up. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.